Welcome! In this video, we discuss and solve problems about markup and markdown. Markup is selling price minus cost, that is, selling price equals cost plus markup. Now, markup comprises of overhead expenses and profit, that is, markup equals expenses plus profit. Selling price can thus be presented as cost plus expenses plus profit, or S equals C plus E plus P. Now, the seller can offer to reduce the regular selling price in order to increase sales. The amount of reduction in the selling price by the seller is what we call markdown. Yes, we've talked about reduction in price before, from the perspective of the buyer, and we call that discount. In essence, when the seller issues a markdown on their selling price, the buyer gets a discount. So, sale price equals regular selling price minus the amount of markdown, or the amount of markdown equals regular selling price minus sale price. And the rate of markdown is the amount of markdown divided by the regular selling price. In terms of trade discounts, these formulas can be presented as amount of trade discounts equals list price minus net price. And the rate of trade discounts equals amount of discounts divided by list price. Now let's solve some problems. A hardware store buys scrub pants at $7 each. Operating expenses are 30% of cost, and required profit is 50% of cost. That is, expenses equals 0.3 times $7, which is $2.10, and profit equals 0.5 times $7, which is $3.50. So for part A, selling price equals cost plus expenses plus profit, and that would give $12.60. For part B, markup can be found by adding expenses and profit, or by selling price minus cost, and that is $5.60. In part C, we have a 15% markdown. That is, the regular price of $12.60 is reduced by 15%, so the clearance sale price will be $10.71. Number 2. A store purchases a fitness tracker at $59.40. Overhead expenses are 10% of selling price, and the required profit is 30% of selling price. So, starting again with selling price equals cost plus expenses plus profit, we have S equals 59.4 plus 0.1S plus 0.3S. Adding the 0.1S and the 0.3S gives 0.4S, and bringing the 0.4S to the left of the equal sign, we have S minus 0.4S equals 59.4. That is 0.6S equals 59.4. Thus, the regular selling price equals $99. Now, during an inventory sale, the tracker was marked down to $64.35 from the regular selling price of $99. So the amount of markdown is 99 minus 64.35, which gives 34.65. The rate of markdown is therefore the amount of markdown divided by the regular selling price, which is 0.35 or 35%. In part C, we need the operating profit due to the sale. So we can solve for profit in the selling price formula, but with selling price replaced with sale price. So profit equals sale price minus cost minus expenses, which is 10% of regular selling price or 9.9. And that gives a profit of negative 4.95, that is a loss of $4.95. Let's examine one more. A spring jacket that costs a retailer $75 less 35%, 20% is marked up 200% of cost. That is, the retailer received a discount series of 35% and 20%. So cost to the retailer is $75 minus 35% minus 20%, and that is $39. Since markup is 200% of cost, then the amount of markup is 2 times cost, which is $78. The regular selling price is thus cost plus markup, which gives $117. In C, if expenses are 40% of cost, then expenses are 0.4 times 39, which gives $15.60. Now, markup equals expenses plus profit, that is 78 equals 15.6 plus profit. And solving for profit, we have $62.40. In D, we want a break-even price, the selling price at which profit equals zero, that is selling price equals cost plus expenses, which gives $54.60. Finally, in part E, the jacket was marked down $29.25. So the sale price equals regular selling price of $117 minus the amount of markdown, which gives $87.75. The amount of markup on cost realized during the sale will be sale price minus cost, and that gives $48.75. The rate of markup on cost realized is thus the amount of markup realized divided by cost, and that gives 1.25 or 125%. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.